Let's start with the session of modeling multivideo. So basically this session is going to be on how do you write a VNF descriptor which has multiple videos in it, and how your network service is going to look like when you're going to onboard it from OSM. So this is all you'll be seeing here. So let's to understand how to write a multivideo VNF, we need to first identify what a network service you're going to onboard, and how are the constructs going to be in it, and how is the modeling taken care in our VNF descriptors. So that will be the whole thing we'll be taking care in the session. So for next one half, we're going to see that. So let me quickly jump into the slides, which the audience new and old. So for the past, from Monday, we were seeing a network slice which was orchestrated from OSM. So this slice as a whole is something, okay, so this is built on an open source, so this is new. This Magma was built on an open source project, and we have different elements in it. We have two different network services here. The first network service is something built on KNF, which is built by KNF basis. And the second network service is the Magma Access Gateway, the EPC element. And this network service, which you see over here, is the gray box, is going to consist of your Magma EPC VNF plus your PNF. So this is about the second network service here. So there are two network services in this entire slice, and which we'll be concentrating now on the VNF part is the Magma Access Gateway VNF. And this VNF is something which consists of two different elements, which is in two different videos, you can call it. So these videos are nothing but the ultimate deployment units of your network function. So they're going to be VMs which will be provisioned in your infrastructure manager. So this is something we have to understand how they are going to be returned in our descriptors. So coming to the part, so let us to give an overview of each video. So the first video which will be in this VNF is nothing but a Magma Access Gateway video. And this video is a main EPC element. And this element is a core component. So it is going to consist of MME, your service gateway, all those built in it. And this is made available image in our HCVim, and as well as it is an open source, like you can get it from our FTPs. So this image, you can find it. And coming to the second video, this is something, and as you know, the emulator video, it's based on SRS LTE. And this video is also unbuilt. And here we have an interesting thing here, because this video is totally based on Ubuntu 20, and all necessary things, that is your to bring up packages in it, to emulate it, we are going to take care of as part of configurations. So that that sums up the video for emulator. Next, coming to the networking things, like so what we saw now is two videos here. So this overall diagram, what you see is consisting of a management network and a network which connects to the physical router. So this router is something which is emulated in our VIM. So this is lying there. So basically we need to connect our Magma Access Gateway to this PNF. And of course we need our OSM to know about this PNF. So we will be seeing more about PNF and how to construct all those in upcoming sessions. And coming to the KNF, the element manager. So this is something on Helm based. And this element manager, Helm based also, we have an upcoming session. So you'll get to know how to write KNF and how the charts are returned there. So I'm going now into the specific parts here. So only we are now going to take a deep look, like how this VNF really looks, like a conceptual or a logical view. So let me go to that slide. So if you see over here, what we taught is a whole network service. That is, so we are now trying to zoom in to this blue dotted box. So if you see over here in this network service, the HackFest Magma Gateway, you know, VNFD is there, And for this VLFD, we have three different connection points. So when we say that there are three different connection points, so how are they going to be named? So logically from this diagram, I need a management access for me to configure and to operate, to have control over my VDUs. So I need a management internet network for them. And same way, for my traffic to go out, I am connecting it to my PNF router. This is something I should expose it from my VNF. So explicitly, I am going to expose a management and the interface which is going to talk to my PNF. And there's one another interface which would be interested, which makes a connectivity between two VDUs. And this is going to be an internal network for my VDUs to communicate. So that is shown over here. So when internal things will get more grasped when we see the video duct slide. So here over in this diagram, if you see, you'll be finding three connection points as we talked. So for that magma, and the three connection points are nothing but these are the interfaces or these are the entities which helps your VNF to be connected to the virtual link. So the access for the magma, the first VDU, so for managing both VDUs, we are going to expose different management interfaces from both the VDUs. So the first connection point, access gateway management, and the second connection point is the SRS LTE's management. So both these connection points are going to be exposed from our VNF. And similarly, the third one, which is going to be connected to our router, is going to be exposed as a connection point, which will be used, being connected to our SGI network. So this would be the whole picture of our VNF. And now coming to the main part, where my VDU lies and how am I going to construct those VDUs. So for that, I'm going to give a closer look at the VNF inside it. So now we have got into the VNF, where I'm going to say I need two VDUs and the resources for those VDUs, and how am I going to write those interfaces, and what are the requirements for both these VDUs. So coming to the first VDU, the access gateway, the main element. So the image, we are going to give the image name, which is magma101, which is present in our VIMs, and the VM flavor required for this access gateway. And coming to the interfaces, so when I deploy my VMs, I need the real interfaces to come up and to be attached to my connection point. So these are going to be the connection points are something your OSM is going to understand to logically anchor it to the interfaces. So you will find three different interfaces in the access gateway, and the three interfaces are going to be logically grouped now, which is going to be exposed outside or which is going to be an internal connection. So that will sum up the first VDU. And coming to the second VDU, you have an SRS LTE emulator. So this VDU is built on an Ubuntu 20 as raw image, and then we have additional components which will be, as I said earlier, it's going to be built as part of our day one configurations. So you will get all those components getting built up there. And coming to the flavor, we have dedicated 4 CPU, 6 GB RAM and 100 GB hard disk, and this is something you'll be giving as an input in your descriptor. And the interface part is again comes the interface where we are going to logically say these are the interfaces which my VM should have. So that we'll give it under the VDU section. So we need two interfaces here, one for management and one which am I going to use it to the next VDU. So that would sum up for second VDU. And coming to the main part of connection points and the VLD sections. So if you see here in first VM, we saw that the first VDU, the access gateway VDU, wanted to establish a communication to my management network. So the virtual link, which is exposed out. So for that, I'm going to expose it as a connection point. So this connection point will be used as a reference when my virtual link, say when I onboard this network service, my VDU will spin up, and then I need to connect that network. I need to connect this VM with this network. So management, the connection point for access gateway will act as an anchor point for me to attach it to the VM. So in this case, I'm going to declare the first two connection points, that is the first two interfaces or second interface, it's of your choice. And let's say that the two interfaces, I'm going to expose it out. So the expose it out in the sense, they're going to act as an external connection points. And these will be used to communicate between DNS or outside your network service. So these are the points which will be referenced outside of VNF are called as external connection points. And you have to name them of that type as called external connections. And then coming to the other interface, which will be used for your SRLTE. So that interface is something is not exposed outside your VNF. It is something needed only for your other video to communicate. And this network is not going to be managed outside by an operator. Rather, this network is something created at instantiation time. And then when a service, when you deploy a delete your service, this network is going to get demolished. It is something provisioned with your service and get deleted there. And for this, we have to again declare the connection point, which will be referenced for connecting to my new internal network. And this connection point will again map to my one of the physical interface, which the video actually has. Similar way, coming to the SRS, we have the other end where the interface will be, connection point will be mapped to an interface, and this will get connected to my internal VLD. So this VLD is totally inside the scope of VNF, and this is not going to lie in the picture of network service as a whole. And coming to the IPs, today there are certain handlers for you where you can say, I need a fixed IP for my interfaces. And these IPs are something which I need for my videos only to know. These need not be in a, which need not be maintained by my operator, or which need not be used for my external things. So for that reason, I'm going to fix my internal IPs. So this would be the overall picture of the entire VNF. So yeah, this sums up the whole VNF things of the video. So I know majorly this covers what we have to design or what we have to model in our descriptor, VNF descriptor. So yeah, knowing all this information, let's say we wanted to start from scratch. I wanted to create a VNF package. From where do I start? So you're going to log in the OSM dashboard. So under your VNF package section, you would be finding a VNF package dropdown, wherein it will allow you to create your new packages. You should find the icon over top right, which says compose a new VNF. And this new VNF something will show a pop-up for you, which is going to give you a name. You can enter a name for your package and give create. So basically by that, you will get a base template for your VNF descriptor. So in that VNF descriptor, you can start adding your content, that is the list of videos you want and the list of connection points and the list of configurations you needed for each video. So this would be the content which will go into your VNF descriptor. So starting from it, let's see if we can create one from CLI as well. So I would copy paste this command. So I'll explain all this command as well. So how it goes. So yeah. So coming to the package create command. So CLI has a provision for you to create it from scratch, wherein it will allow you to say which directory I wanted to use, what is my image required for my video, and followed by the CPU count, memory, what is required for my video, storage, and these are certain handlers only. So followed by vendor, and the final two things are important, wherein it says which type of, which category it belongs, the package what I'm creating, and the name for it. So if I just click enter, you should be seeing something like this, which creates a package structure for you. The VNF package structure, which is necessary for the OSM VNF onboarding. So let's just list the content of it. Mm. As you can see, it has appended me with a VNF suffix where it gives me says that this package is a VNF. And if you list the content, you will find that there are different folder structures there, and out of which the YAML file is something where you are going to give in your contents of the entire descriptor, and the CloudInit is going to hold all your cloud config files. And coming to the charts, these are the charts which will be used for configurations. Basically for your videos, so that in deeper you will look in later sessions. And the remaining is something which can be used for your packages. So this would sum up for the entire VNF package creation. So let me jump into this session again. So I think already you would have cloned this package for our repo, the Magma repo. So we have the final content which you are going to onboard for this session is going to be in this content where already Mark has pointed. So you'll find a directory called Magma, and the VNFD is what we were been discussing for this session as Access Gateway VNFD, and the other VNFDs as well would be found in this repository. So let me quickly go there. And another thing is that let me also quickly show the descriptor, which was created from scratch. So how it looks like. So this is a descriptor of what we had given as input in the command. So it has created one section of video and the basic file with following the key called VNF catalog. So this helps to identify that this is a VNF descriptor and all. And coming down, now you would find a list of section called videos. So the number of videos can be declared under this section. So we are going to edit this content. For time reasons, we are not going to type it. So we are just going to have a look at the descriptor, which is already cloned from our repo. So let me quickly go there. So this is the entire repo. So you would find all our packages here, and out of which the package which we would be concentrating now is the Magma's VNFD package. You can traverse here, and we have the following explanation for all these contents. The entire thing needed for our network service to be done is given in this entire descriptor. So we are going to take a look at each of the section and understand how it has been written from our logical diagram to the descriptor language, which OSM basically understands. So yeah, again moving to our slide. So I hope my screen is visible again. Here I have expanded this section where it shows the video interfaces. So we have, as you know, in the diagrammatic representation, we saw that there were two videos, and the first video, the Access Gateway video. So in your YAML, you would find a section called video. Under that, a Magma Access Gateway video will be there. Sorry about that. So you will be finding a Magma Access Gateway video and the interfaces. So now we are going to start declaring our interfaces. So you would find three different interfaces there. So starting from ETH0, ETH1, and ETH2. And coming here, so we said something that when interfaces are declared, so I have given a list, and now I have to identify which would be of type internal and which would be used for my external purposes. So internal is something going to be used only between your videos. So the first interface, we are going to use it for internal purpose, that is VM to VM communication, that is only the Access Gateway and the eNodeB is going to communicate. So for that purpose, I'm going to declare it as internal type. And what is my virtual interface type? And there are certain types available. We are going with Paravert here. And then coming to the internal connection point reference. So this is something necessary for your orchestrator to identify when I'm creating that virtual link to which interface, and I have to go and logically map this. So this connection point is going to give you that reference, and how this interface will get mapped to that virtual link is taken care of by this access gateway S1. So the internal network, what is going to be created is S1, as we are just logically naming it here. And then coming to the second two interfaces, I mean second and third interfaces. So we have declared an interface which is going to be used for external purpose, that is from access gateway to the router. So that interface is something of type external, so which is going to be exposed outside of VMF. So I'm going to give the type as external there. Really sorry. So which is going to be of type external, and then the so again here comes a type which says if it is of type external, how am I going to refer this point? So that is also again mentioned with the key called external connection point reference and a logical name which helps us to identify that this interface will be used for a connection point called access gateway SGI. And same way the third interface which will be used for my management purpose. And this interface is again the access gateways VDU's management interface. So this interface will be used for my configuring to configure my entire VDU to apply day one configurations and all day one day two configurations. And this would sum up the entire interface, how to declare and how do I go with the types and how do I give the categorization with. And coming to the next point, the internal connection points which are declared in the descriptor. So here if you find, you will see that there is something called access gateway S1. So what is this access gateway S1? So we have declared, so this is the actual declaration of the internal connection point. And when I declared my interfaces, you would have noticed that the internal connection point was referring here. And this will help to map the interface with my connection point. And you would find also the OSM now have some capabilities which can instruct you to do certain things on your created ports. So one such thing would be disabling the port security for particular interface. So that is given with a key called port security enabled with a key, with a Boolean value which helps to identify to disable or enable. So that would be the entire interface section of first VDU. I'm coming to the next part where, so we have declared the interface detail, and we know that the access gateways management point should be exposed. So we should help the VNF to identify which will be my management interface. So for that, I'm declaring a key called management interface, in that you will find a connection point which is referring to that access gateway management. And there are a set of connection points which are going to be exposed. So we'll see that also how it is declared in VNF. So I'm just pointing out the first connection point as whole VNF which will be exposed. So that is then the first VDU management alone. And then coming to the next section is something on the day zero configurations. So I have VDU now. I wanted to do all the day zero operations, that is some kind of boot operations when the VDU boots up. I have to take in all the necessary details of username, password, say some additional commands you have to run while boot up, and some packages needed, all those things. So all those I'm going to take care, and with the help of the cloud file, then we basically call it as a cloud config. And this would be a file. So this file would you could find in the magma directory of CloudInit. There'll be a CloudInit directory, and within that you should find an file named it as magma access gateway init. So this about this file we'll take a deeper look later. So this is the content which is going to be used for my day zero. And coming to the second VDU, yeah, so we have seen the first VDU and their entire declaration part and all. So of course you would have a similar section where it says VM flavor, image name and all in the for access gateway VDU also. So that would be for the first VDU. For the second VDU, if you see the SRS LTE VDU, basically the emulator. For this VDU, you would find the two interface which are very necessary for us to deploy. So in this interface section, you would find two interfaces, one of type external. So this is going to be used by as my management interface to be giving a control to manage and to configure my VDU. And in order to again know this interface is going to be used for my management purpose, I'm going to give a key which states it as true. So this will help the orchestrator to identify that this interface, which is of type which has been exposed, I'm going to actually use it for my management purpose. And then coming to the ETH one, so this interface is the second interface which we taught in the diagram. So this interface, we are going to declare it as type internal, and this is going to be overall connected to my VDU, the second VDU, which is SRS LTS one. So two VDUs are going to be connected via the private network, right? The internal VLD basically. So for that, this interface is going to be used. And again comes the section where you have the internal connection point declared. So this helps to identify which is my connection point of type internal. And then we'll have an overall structure where it says how to connect these two internal points. So that would be also declared in the VNFD descriptor. So that would come up later. So this is about the interfaces and how you take care of writing the internal connection points. And the first section, I mean, if you see, there will be a top section, again, which identifies the VM flavor and all. As I said, this SRSLTE is based on Ubuntu 20. So we are going to use Ubuntu 20 as base image and then construct upon it. And then the description and the count for VDU, how much VDUs you need in it, all this comes under the count key. So this will be the two VDUs and the final thing which you would notice in your VNFD packet is something called as internal VLD. So what is this VLD? So VLDs are nothing but virtual link descriptor. So as we saw that there are two different connection points, like internal and external, where internal connection point is going to be used between your VDUs, not primarily going to be exposed outside your VNF. Same way, this internal VLD is something, the network, which is going to be used between your VDUs only. So we are going to take care of it in the VNF descriptor itself. So you will find a section called internal VLD there, which will have a name for it. And I'm just describing the link here. So I have one important key field here called as IP profile ref. This is something interesting for you to understand. Like this helps the your Vim. Say suppose I wanted to create a network which I wanted. Like you can go for a user defined network with fixed set of IP addresses and so on. So this is going to be taken care with help of IP profiles. And if you see in this internal VLD section, I have given a proper name for this VLD. And then followed by the internal connection point reference. One would refer to my access gateway's S1 interface, and the second one would be to the VDU 2, which is SRSLTE S1. And then, if I wanted to go for a fixed IP address for that interface, I'm going to give one with a subnet declared under this IP profile ref. So we'll see the IP profile ref first. So coming here, I know that I need an internal virtual link, and I can even give it to Vim to have its own created network, but rather I'm going for a fixed network, which say for that you have a handle called IP profiles. There I have given a name followed by the subnet details, the DHCP parameters, what you require in it. All those can be given under this IP profile construct, and this proper name, proper and a unique name is going to be a key for you to declare in the internal VLD. So this is what referred here as IP profile ref. And by this way, your VLD, when it is created and your connection point tries to attach it to a network, they're going to attach it to this internal S1 network. And the interface, when it is coming up, they're going to create a port with a specified or a fixed IP address, you can call. So they'll come up with these two IPs. So this would be the entire VNF package. So the final thing. So I have created both VDUs now. I have gone for the resources, interfaces, and how are the mappings for internal to be taken care and all. So within VNF, all are taken care. Now I have to expose certain points which will be used outside my VNF, as we have taught for management and for the TNF purpose, the data traffic purpose. So for that, we are going to have two different management interface. So we have already declared the connection points, that is whether it's an external or an internal. So I'm going to give a declaration which says the list of connection points which will be exposed from these VNF, access gateway management and SRS LTE management. And third one is that interface which is connected towards my router. So if you could imagine, so these are the three connections. So yeah, so these are these three connection points which we have declared under the connection point section. First two from the first video and the management of the SRS LTE video. So all these have been exposed. So we have given this section called connection points. Your VNF is done and ready. Now we'll start moving into network service. So yeah, coming to network service part. So having a VNF in hand, I should start creating a network service which will refer to my VNF. So this network service is an will encapsulate all your tasks. So for here, to create one from scratch, again you can go ahead to VNF OSM UI, where you'll be having a section called packages. And in that you would find NS packages, and again top right where you find the compose new VNF, and on clicking that you would get a pop-up where you can give a unique name for your package to be identified. And again, this is going to create a base template for you, and within this template you can start giving your content. And this content, how it is going to be, we are going to have a look based on the Magma. In similar way, we do have an option to create from CLI. So this packet, so when I say create from CLI, it is going to have a different packet structure. So yeah, let's see one thing. Let's get that one as well. So yeah, so coming to explanation of this command, where it says package create, and I'm going to point to my base directory. So we have created Magma one directory and host system, right? So that Magma directory will be there, followed by vendor, and again comes the type. So which type of package I'm creating? So here comes the network service type. So I'm giving NS, followed by a name for this package. So yeah, so if you see, it would have created a structure for you, and this contents goes in as such, where you have a descriptor, network service descriptor YAML, and followed by you have a charms directory where you can write your NS level charms will be placed here, and this goes as a whole package. We'll be onboarding these packages shortly. So yeah, again, these are in order for you to refer the packages, what I'm going to describe now would be found in the directory of the OSM packages what we have cloned. You can go to packages Magma. You'll find the content here, the descriptor YAML, which says which has the necessary information in order for my VNF to emulate my VNFD. And I'm going to show this in detail of how this we arrived at this descriptor. So let me again jump into the presentation. So yeah, the descriptor what you would be seeing would be of something like this. So it would refer both VNF, the access gateway VNF as well as the VOS VNF. So we won't concentrate on that as we said earlier. So I'm going to explain on the first VNF how it has been written, how it has been encapsulated in our NS package. So coming to the first part, which you would need to know in while writing your NS is something known as constituent VNFD. So constituent VNFD is a section which gets you to know what are my VNF that I'm going to use in this network service. So this key helps your orchestrator to get those packages ready and get it deployed. So here you would find a key called constituent VNF in the descriptor, where we have the member VNF index, and this you can give a logical name for it. So this is going to be used as a key you can call, and then followed by the descriptor ID refer. And in descriptor ID reference, we have to refer the VNF package name. By this way, OSM will take the VNF descriptor and onboard it to them. Like while instantiating, we will point to the network service descriptor only. So by this means, this will help the OSM to automatically point to my VNF. So this would be the first part. And the second part would be the networking details. So how am I going to connect all my VNFs? So this VNF, the access gateway VNF, what we saw is that VNF is having both management network and a network called SDI to be connected to my the peering one, which is the router. So in the VLD section, if you see, you would find a network name called management, and this management is a net. So this can be a logical name, the ID name and short name, what you see over here, and followed by the VNFD connection point reference. So this is an important element which is going to identify my external virtual link, whatever I'm creating, what are the interfaces or what are the connection points that my network service should use to connect to this VLD, the external VLD, or my management network is going to use. So I know that VNF has exposed certain connection points which we had declared as connection point in our VNF descriptor. So with that help, I'm going to say how it is written here. So you will find a section called VNF connection point reference. And within it, you would find two let me again go to the diagram for in order to get an easier view. So this would be the diagram. Now we are declaring the VLD of which is of type external. So the part which is highlighted in blue are the one we are going to describe in our NS descriptor. So coming here, we have already in VNF D, we had given three connection points basically, and out of which two will be used for management. So this is something I'm going to start declaring in my NS descriptor under VLD section. And this will be the third one. So let me again quickly go there. So we are using those two management and connection point reference to be connected to this network, and I'm giving a management network key as true, which will help my network service to identify that this network is something going to be used for my configuration purpose, and they'll identify the config management network in my VIM. So basically, I've created a VIM with a management network. So they'll try to attach the connection point to those network which was configured as management. So this key is going to get you done that. And coming to the next network, which is going to be connected towards my router. So the VLD, which is going to connect Magma Access Gateway, and the router is the SDI network. So here also you have construct which can go accordingly to your according to your build. So in our HC, we have the SDI network pre-created, and PNF is already connected there. So if you see there, you would find then VLD key called VLD with that set of names for the network, like name, ID and key. And followed by the VNF connection point reference, where they are pointing to the exact VNF, and followed by the package from which we are going to refer it, and then the connection point which will be used for this VLD. And the important key is the Vim network name. If you have a pre-created network which is lying in your Vim, you can use this key to help your orchestrator identify that I need this network service to use the network which is already existing in my Vim. So this key is going to do that for you. So that would be the VLD section of the network service package. Yeah, so far what we have seen, we have seen the constructs for describing the VDU, the connection points, internal, external, and if it is of type internal and external, how the VLDs are represented, all those of going to constructs of NS and VNF we have seen. There was one important part that we saw as cloud init for each of the VDUs. So cloud init is something like day zero configurations. So all day zero configurations for your VNF, that is VDUs, the deployment units, are going to be done through this cloud config files only. So that is something we are going to take a look at. So cloud config files are very easy. So you can have a look in the directory of Magma under cloud config directory, where you'll find two different files. So these cloud config files are from a Linux package, and they are very easy to write. And these comes in config drive and OpenStack metadata servers. And not all Vim supports this, but according to the Vim type you use, you have to use the particular cloud config files to be used. And this cloud config file can be used across a variety of OS. Mainly it supports in Linux based VMs. And the other OSs, they may be supports, so it depends on the OS as well. So this will be a little hint on what is cloud init. And coming to the part with cloud init, what all can be done? Like, what can you configure in your VDUs as part of day zero? So for that, these are very limited what is listed here. You have many things that can be done. So you can find the doc link there, which you can access as well. So setting host name, setting username, passwords. Say I wanted to configure my network, and then adding specific user and groups, adding certain type of files, installing some necessary packages. All those can be done in your cloud init, according to your use cases. So we are going to take a look at the Magma Access Gateway's cloud init. So in this particular directory, you are going to see the cloud init file. So if you go to your Magma Access Gateway init, you would find a cloud init file, something like this. So this cloud init file is used for our Access Gateway VDU. So when VM boots up, your Vim, your underlying Vim, is going to ensure that these day zero cloud data are being applied to your VDU. And then if you see over here, you would find something as orchestration IP, which is enclosed within curly braces. So this is something which OSM is going to provide as form of instantiation parameter. Say suppose you create the package and everything, and when onboarding service, I wanted to give some user-defined parameters. So how do I take care of it? It's done through this instantiation parameter. So you're going to fill in the data of orchestration IP. The key will be orchestration IP. This key will be passed with the help of an instantiation parameter during our launching our service or instantiating our service. So this IP goes in like that, and the other routes, what you see in this file is entirely with the network of etc and the Vim what you are currently using. So if you are trying to do it in your own environment, the routes and so on should be changed according to it. So that would be for the access gateway, the cloud config. And the second VDU what we have is SRS LTE. So for this since it is purely based on Ubuntu, what we are trying to do here is we are going to set a password for this username password. And if you find here the interesting thing, the packages, when my VM boots up, I needed some essential packages which should be ready before my service starts. So I should ensure that it is part of day zero. So that is taken care under with Cloud NF. And coming to the run command, so you have again a set of routes needed for our SRS to send traffic. So this is again with the network what we have in our Ravel. So this routes may change if you have if you wish to provision it in your network. So this is all about the SRS LTE. And yeah, so we can start onboarding the packages to OSM. So what I would do is so you're going to start onboarding the packages. Like we have the Magma directory which we had cloned. So with that we'll be able to upload the packages to OSM. So while for uploading, again we have the OSM CLI command. So for that command, what you have is an OSM NF package create and path to the VNF package. So what it is going to do for you is nothing but so this every single command is going to on validate your package, build the package as star, the format which is required for my orchestrator, and then they are going to upload it to the finally upload to my OSM. So all these three things are done with every single command you apply for each VNF package. So you have created your VNF package, NS package. Now you're going to start onboarding the NS and the VNF package. But the thing is, when you try to onboard these packages, you have to use two different commands of NF package and the NS package. And here, after onboarding, since it's a whole slice we are going to onboard, we are going to onboard three different packages from our Magma directory. Okay, so you'll be finding something as Magma KNF and the Access Gateway VNFT, what we had seen so far, and the VNFT which was used for the EOS router. So all these three VNF we are going to onboard. So once you're onboarded, you should be able to list it with the help of command NF package list. So by that means, it will be all these three packages, whatever you've onboarded, it would be seen there. And the next command would be onboarding your network service package. So for that, again, from the Magma directory, in the Magma directory, you should be finding the NS packages for the eNodeB NSD and the Magma orchestrator, that is the KNF's NS. So I request to onboard all these three packages from VNF and same way for NS. And once you have onboarded all these two packages, and then finally comes a slice package. So since this whole network service is incorporated within slice, we are going to onboard that as well. So I would request again to OSM to follow this command. You can go into the directory of Magma and follow this command to onboard the slice. So that you should be able to list the template and which says the template is successfully onboarded. So if you're done with it, you should be able to see VNF package, NS package, and the next slice template. And yeah, one final thing, since we have the new environment, I hope all have onboarded your packages. So before that, also, since the environment was newly given, just ensure that you add the Helm repo, which is going to be used for the KNF. And after onboarding the slice, also ensure the PDUs are onboarded. The PNF, so basically the slice is incorporating the PNF. So we have onboarded this VNF package, the PNF package as a gateway VNFB, and the KNF package. So all these were onboarded, and then the network service package, this whole thing was onboarded, and then this EPC and the slice template. So after onboarding all this, just ensure you have the Vim account in hand, Vim account added, KX cluster added, and yeah, of course, the PDU. So there'll be more about how to write a PDU YAML, how to add it and all. But think what you would do for this session. Okay. So just go to the template directory and you will find a file called pdu.yaml. Once your BIM account is added, you can quickly grab the BIM ID with the help of this command and replace it in the PDU YAML. And then onboard the PDU into OSM so that your OSM now aware will be aware of what the PDU is. So just ensure you have all this in hand, and then we can go for slice instantiation. So we saw about the descriptors, how to onboard, how to write them, how to onboard the packages, how all can be done. And there was one thing which can be taken from user end as an instantiation parameter. So here what you would do is something called, you would find a dev file in the magma directory which says params.yaml, and this YAML is going to be as an input file when I onboard my network slice for this. And you have different YAMLs. You can construct different YAMLs. It depends upon your network service you wanted. Like say the network slice what we are seeing now needs input for both VNFBs. So for that reason, we have the net slice template subnet as a whole, followed by for each NSD, what is the input parameter we require. And if you remember, we had an orchestration IP which is supposed to be given as instantiation parameter. So we are going to fix with the IP which should be given in your sheet of the magma orchestration IP. You will find a column next to each tenant ID, and you can go ahead and fill this IP and make this YAML ready. So this is one thing we are going to give as an fill in as an input when I start creating my slice. So coming to the final part, we have onboarded, we have made our instantiation parameters ready as a form of YAML. What the command to onboard my network NetSlice template, that is, I'm going to instantiate that. So what it takes for it is, you have to start, I would just start explaining this command so that it will be clear, wherein it says NSI create followed by NSI name, a specific name for our slides, and then followed by the template name. So this template is something we have onboarded to OSM now, followed by the config file. So this config file is nothing but the set of instantiation parameter what we have made ready, and the BIM account. So this BIM account is nothing but you have to display your OSM BIM list, so where it shows the current BIM account for which you would be instantiating this slice. So that would be the BIM account here. And coming so with help of this command, you would be able to instantiate the entire slice. And of course, I have instantiated the slice, and you can follow up of the slice, like whether it's onboarded, how it is configured. That can be done from OSM NetSlice instance list, which is going to give you the NetSlice instance onboarded, whether it is in init state, creating state, what is the current status of which the NetSlice is being done now. And then if you remember, this slice was consisting of two different NS. Even you can have a close look at the NS by showing this command, which will help you to list the network service. The network service, what the slice has deployed. And this is all we talked with respect to the magma slice, so what we have in our Git clone. See, suppose I just have a network service and I wanted to onboard that network service, what should be done? So for that, you can go ahead with the command called osm-create, where you have to give a name, unique name for your network service, followed by your network service package name, and then the BIM account. So again, which BIM you have indicated to your orchestrator to be used. And if suppose it contains an instantiation parameters, you can go ahead giving the instantiation parameter for it. And this would be the command, commands to onboard, that is to launch your NetSlice instance or your NS separately. So for this session, we'll limit ourselves with onboarding the entire slice. So if tenants who don't have any, I think from tenant 1 to 30, there's no issues. So once you have onboarded the packages and the slice template, you can go ahead and create the slice, which will onboard two different VDUs in OpenStack. So this will something look like, so this is how it will look like in our OSM page. If you look on onboarding the net slice, on instantiating the net slice, you would find the net slice instances page, which says the net slice is being configured and running. And yeah, the network service. So if you take a look at the network service, we have onboarded two network services. One was for the EPCs and one was for the EPC management. That is the Magma KNF basically. So two NFs will be active. And if you take a look at the OpenStack network topology, this would represent something like this, where you have two VDUs being launched, where one will be the access gateway and the second one would be the SRS LTE connected to our external network, since this was used as management while configuring your builds. And then the SDI network used for the router, where the router ultimately runs. And the internal network, which is used to connect our two VDUs. So this would sum up the entire deployment of slice.